The most expensive part of smartphones is the display, and that's because there's a thin coating of a unique type of material that's both transparent and electrically conductive. Solar cells, LED displays, and touchscreens all use this coating. A new class of materials discovered by Penn State scientists could be a cheaper alternative as well as pave the way for new types of technology.
If you, for example, look at the bill of materials for smartphones, it turns out that you're paying more for the display than for the battery, the camera, the CPU, and the memory together.
For decades, indium tin oxide has been the most commonly used transparent conductor. It's used in more than 90% of all display and touchscreen devices. However, the manufacturing of indium tin oxide film faces substantial hurdles, including decreasing availability and rising costs. Despite many years of research, there has been no clear replacement.
The challenge is to combine a very high optical transparency and a very high electrical conductivity. You could think of materials that are electrically conducting, like copper, but they are not optically transparent, they are reflective. And vice versa, you could think of materials that are optically transparent, like glass, but they are not electrically conducting. So the question is, how do you bring these two things together?
The traditional approach used to create transparent conductors, such as indium tin oxide, is to add a conductive element to a transparent material to improve its electrical properties.
And this is how this game is played over the past 50, 60 years. What we did is we took the opposite approach. We said, why don't we take a metal that's very, very conducting, but it's reflective, and we work with the material to make it become more and more transparent. And so we moved ahead and we looked into a new class of materials. We call them correlated metals. And it turns out that these correlated metals fit that bill equally well and actually sometimes even better.
Dr. Engel-Herbert combines two methods for creating thin films to create a unique hybrid growth technique that plays off the advantages of each.
And that has been a very successful approach. So we've been able to grow very high quality material to study the intrinsic properties of it. The way we're doing this is literally from the ground up. So we're starting with the elements, we're putting them in fusion cells, and we're supplying them in a controlled fashion using shutters and heating them up to create fluxes, and those fluxes then fall on crystalline surfaces. And we can literally build a material from the grounds up layer by layer, almost as much as you would cook and bake a lasagna. You know, it goes layer by layer, and you put a little bit of secret sauce to it as well. And so what we can do now in a very controlled fashion, find the right composition and study what the physical properties would be. And as soon as we find interesting candidates, we then try to transfer this to a more scalable thin film growth technique, so make it more economically viable.
This discovery, which began with strontium vanadate, could in the future allow us to create completely transparent displays. That will be useful in a range of next generation devices, such as virtual reality and anywhere else one might want a transparent touchscreen or display device.
And it turns out that this new class of correlated metals offer some solutions that currently don't exist. So it gives us a lot of flexibility and it solves some of the technical issues that we are facing if we would just go with the conventional indium tin oxide-like wide bandgap semiconductor. Strontium vanadate is just one example of a transparent conductor. Right now we are working on different types of composition that follow the same new design principle that we've discovered. What I believe is that there's going to be new technology that could emerge from this. What's exciting for me is that this is just the beginning, because we are realizing with the new research that is currently going on in the lab that this is just the tip of the iceberg.